Hi, I'm Sadie. I'm so excited to be dancing with you today. This video is going to be featuring a topic that I am most passionate about and is definitely one of the most exciting portions of belly dance, and that is the drum solo. My fans and colleagues have crowned me the queen of the drum solo, and now, in this video, I will share with you the knowledge and tricks of the trade I have collected over the years. I also have a few surprises for you. My friends, Kareem Nagy, master percussionist, and Atlantis Long, producer of the Belly Dancer of the Universe, will also be here to share some of their secrets. Please enjoy my drum solo secrets. As dancers, our posture is going to be the foundation for proper technique. So we're going to start right at the feet. I want you to have nice flat feet on the floor. Your feet should never really be more than shoulder width apart when you're doing any kind of drills, and I actually like to have my feet a little bit closer than that. So you can even have them almost all the way together. From there, we're going to go to the knees. We always want to have a soft bend, or what is also known as a plié, in the knees. So as you can see here, I'm just plié down just before the knees would actually go over the toes. So you don't want to be so far down that your knees shoot over the toes. You want them behind the toes. But without this plié, without this soft bend in the knees, you're not going to have the range of motion to move the hips. Okay, so you really want to make sure that you can actually have the space to move the hips by having those knees in that bent position. From there, we're going to pull the pelvic under. Okay, so this is essential to protecting your lower spine and essential to your technique. So again, I want you to pull that pelvic under. Think of connecting a line that's going to shoot out your tailbone and connect with your heels. Yeah, you want a straight line that would shoot right out that tailbone and connect with the heels. If your tailbone is not pulled under, if your pelvis is not pulled under, you would notice that line would shoot out in another direction. I want it to connect with those heels. So you're going to feel pretty relaxed in the abdominals. You don't need to do any kind of extra contraction to make that happen. You're just simply correcting your posture so that you have a nice, flat lower back. From here, we're going to move to the upper body, to the rib cage. We're going to lift that rib cage just slightly up and out. This is going to give us that nice, tall, lifted dancer look that we want. We want the shoulders down and relaxed at all times. So if you look at my shoulders, no matter where my arms are, I'm always going to keep my shoulders down. So you can think of pulling those shoulder blades together in the back, keeping those shoulders down. So what I mean is you don't ever want to lift the shoulders up as the arms come up. The shoulders always stay in that dropped position, whether arms are down, whether arms are up, or at the side. Fingers, also very important. No matter where your hands are, you want to make sure that you have energy radiating through the whole body, coming all the way out through the fingertips. One common thing that I see with dancers, especially new dancers, is where they bend the elbows and kind of let the hands droop. So we definitely don't like that look as dancers, right? We want to keep the line of infinity, we call it. So without creating any sharp bends, okay? A sharp bend in the arm is going to kill that line of infinity going out. So we want a nice soft shoulder and soft elbow and energy all the way through. So we're going to be playing with different positions of the arms, coming up, coming down, holding them at the side. We just want to make sure that those shoulders stay in that down, relaxed position. Chin up, right? We don't want to dance with our head down. We want to be communicating with our audience, right, through the solar plexus area and the throat chakra. We really want to stay open and lifted through here. And we want to engage in making contact with our audience. So from the head, right, we're open in our communication center. We have our chest lifted, our shoulders are down, our shoulder blades are together in the back. We have energy all the way through the fingers. Our pelvic stays in that tucked position. Our knees are always softly bent, right? That's going to give us the range of motion to move those hips. And then our feet are firmly planted on the floor, unless I tell you that we're going to be working in releve, and our feet are pretty close together. So it's your job as you're working with this video or that you're practicing your dancing on your own that you're always maintaining this proper posture. It's just not going to be possible for you to have perfect technique without it. As soon as any of this comes out of line, you're going to lose your technique. So as you'll notice, just holding and maintaining proper posture is a workout in and of itself. You might start to feel the quads get a little bit weak. That's a good thing. That means you're going to build those muscles. You need nice, strong quad muscles. You want to make sure that that pelvis is tucked under, right? You might start to feel that core really working. You might start to feel like you're getting warm and shaky in there as well. But I do promise as you work on these techniques to hold that proper form, it's going to get a lot easier. So please make sure that you check in with yourself and that you're always keeping this proper posture as you're dancing today. Middle Eastern music offers us some of the most complex rhythms and melodies known in the musical world. Our job as a dancer is to interpret that musicality to the best of our ability. Today, the dynamic sounds of the dumbek, or the Middle Eastern hand drum, will be our inspiration. We want to match the perfectly defined sounds of the drum's dooms and teks with equally defined body movements known as isolations. In order to keep up with the fast pace of a drum solo, we're going to want to internalize our movements. So we have movements that move outside of the body, right? Right? Slower, softer, slinky moves usually move outside of the body. For a drum solo, we don't have that kind of time. Our accents are super fast, one right after the other. In order to move our body parts that fast, we need to make sure we're moving the body parts inside of the body. For example, I want to keep my hips in the body versus pushing them out. Right? So no matter where we're going to move, that's what the focus of this whole DVD is going to be, working those movements internally inside of the body. So just keep in mind as you're going through this, you don't want to replace the technique with big movements. A lot of times students think, oh, if I make the movement bigger, it'll be stronger, it'll be better. And it's just not true. You're going to really want to call on the muscle groups to help you execute these movements. So the first muscle group that we're going to work with is actually going to be the core obliques. So when we say core, it really just means everything that wraps around. It's the abdominals, which actually wrap all the way around the back and even into the glutes. And we're going to be calling on a lot of those muscles to help assist in these moves. So we're going to start by thinking of the oblique. I want you to think of pulling that hip bone up into the rib cage. You're going to lift it up, and you're going to keep it inside of the body. Okay, so I want you really thinking and focusing on squeezing and contracting that oblique muscle, lifting that hip bone up into the rib cage. Contract, contract. Using that core, using that oblique to actually tilt the hips. We want vertical movement, a vertical isolation on that right hip, pulling it up, up, right? Same thing on the other side. That is going to be the focus of the next drill. We're really pulling that hip bone up into the rib cage. Now, don't forget your posture. Right? You got to have those knees bent and that pelvis tucked under, especially chest lifted, pulling that hip bone up into the rib cage. So really internalizing the movement, keeping those hips inside the body, moving upward. Okay, and that's going to take us into the next drill. Let me go ahead and demonstrate your first drill for you today. So our first drill is really going to be working on those oblique crunches, those oblique isolations, getting that vertical lift and tilt in the hip. So the drill is going to start. I'm going to have you just put all of your weight into your left foot, and then you're going to pull that right foot up into a touched position. So what that means is you're going to be fully weighted on your left. I don't want any weight on the right, and you're not going to be pushing off of this leg. I don't want you to push off this leg. So one thing about the posture we talked about earlier is we want to make sure we don't use those legs as pistons. Anytime we start to pump the leg, we're going to fall out of posture and our technique isn't going to have a chance. So we really want to keep that weight in the left foot. Make sure the knee is bent, and then we're just going to be touched in the right foot. Make sure the pelvis is tucked under. We're going to start here for 32 counts of oblique crunches. After 16 counts, we're going to take the arms up and down. Okay, so I don't want you to worry too much about what the drill is. You'll be able to go ahead and rewind and keep doing the drill over with me. I just want to talk you through it. After that, we're going to speed up. We're going to start with the half time, and then we're going to speed up to the full time hip, and then we're going to go every four counts, half time and full time. And then we're going to add the arms again. So what you're doing is you're going to be doing hip work for 16 counts, followed by hip work with an arm layer for 16 counts. For a total of 32 counts, you're going to switch it over to the other side. Same posture. You're going to do the same drill that you did on your right, now on the left. Then we're going to go ahead and switch back over to the other side. We're going to speed up the hips for 16 counts, and then we're going to add a layer of a snake arm on top of there. Okay, so let's go ahead and try that drill with the music. 7, 8 on the right. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We have 8 more counts right here. Pull that hip bone up into the rib cage. Add the arms. We go up. 2, 3, 4. Take it down. One more time up. You're going to rest those arms at the side. Speed up the hips. Full time. 2, 3, 4. Half time. 6, 7, 8. One more time. Half time. Add the arms. Full time. Half time. Full time. Half time. 6. Change. Up on your left. Oblique crunches. Pulling that hip bone up into the rib cage. 5, 6. Add the arms up and down. Down. 6, 7, 8. Up. Taking it up to full time on your left. Half time. Full time. Half time. Add the arms. Switch to full time on your right. 5, 6, 7, 8. You have 8 more counts right here before we add the arms. Add arms. We're going to go snake arm for 4 counts. We're going to switch sides. Full time on your left. Oblique crunches. Pull that hip bone up into the rib cage. Adding a snake arm on your right for 4 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. Great job. In this next drill, we're going to take the focus to another muscle group in the core, which is going to be our glute muscles. So the glute muscle obviously is behind us, right? We want to go ahead and isolate that muscle, and we're going to be squeezing it. What we want to do here is we want to create a lock. So we're working on isolations in this DVD, and a very specific isolation is known as a lock. A lock is something where you're going to hold and stop the movement. You're going to use a muscle contraction to hold that movement with a little pause and stop it to give it that nice sharp locking look. So that happens in 2 muscle groups. One is the core obliques like we just did, and the other one is going to be the glute working together. So it's the core that actually gives you the vertical tilt that you're looking for, and then it's going to be the glute that's going to give you that sharp locking isolation on top of it. So what we're going to end up doing is take the foot out to the side. The drill is going to be exactly the same as the last drill. We're just going to be in a slightly different position. So you're going to be weighted in the left foot. Your right foot is going to be touched out to the side. And what this does is it allows you to isolate that glute muscle. So from here, what I'm going to want you to do is I'm going to want you to go ahead and squeeze that glute muscle on the side here. Squeeze. Squeeze. I don't want you using the leg as a piston. Remember how we talked about earlier that you don't want to pump the leg? It's not to say that that's a wrong technique. There are times that you want to use that technique when you want a softer, bigger movement. For the drum solo, however, we want to use those muscle groups, which means we are not going to use our leg as a piston. We are going to just keep the leg relaxed, and we're going to squeeze right here in that glute muscle. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. I want you to notice how I'm keeping my hips squared and level. They're not moving. I'm not lifting my hip right now. I'm just taking that glute, and I'm squeezing it. Squeeze. So just by watching this, you can see how much power I can get out of that squeeze. You can see how that would really accent that hip, especially when I add the core contraction on top of there as well. But right now we're just isolating the glute muscle. That is going to be what the next drill is. So you're going to do that on both sides. We're going to end up changing from your right side to your left side, calling on that glute muscle. Same thing over here on the left side. I want to make sure that you're not actually tilting the hip. So we're keeping the obliques relaxed, and we're not pumping the leg. We're just isolating that glute muscle all by itself. This is just a drill to train the muscle right now, so we're not actually doing the lock yet. We're just training the muscle groups that we need to make the lock. So the next drill is actually going to be putting those two together and creating that. So let's go ahead and try the drill where we're going to do the same thing we did in the last drill with the glute squeezes. 5, 6 on your right, half-time squeezes. 5, 6, 7, 8, another measure of 8. We're going to add those arms up and down, up and down. Again, we go up. On our way down, we're just going to rest at the side, take it up to speed full time. Half-time, again. Half-time, we're going to add those arms. One more time, up. Switch sides. Half-time, on your left. Make sure you're isolating just the glute, nothing else is moving, no abs, no legs. Add those arms. Down. One more time, up. Relax the arms at the side, full time. Half time, full time. Add those arms. Half time, coming down, full time. Half time, switch back over to the other side, full time. 5, 6, 7, 8, again. We're gonna add those snake arms. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. Just the glute muscle. Change sides. 16 counts. Full time glute squeeze on your left. 5, 6. Add the snake arm on the right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. Remember to keep practicing that drill over and over till you feel absolutely confident and sure that you're working just the muscle group that we're isolating, which and that one was the glute. Everything else stays relaxed. The abdominals stay relaxed. The legs do not pump. We don't want any vertical tilting out of the hips. We want just isolation of the glute muscle. All right, let's have some fun. We're going to take those oblique crunches and those glute squeezes. We're going to put them together. We're going to be doing them at the same exact time to create a vertical hip isolation or a vertical hip lock. Okay, so we're going to take that squeeze in the oblique and the squeeze in the glute. We're going to do them at the same exact time. We're going to bring that left hip bone up into the rib cage, squeeze and contract. Take it over to the other side. Squeeze and contract. Over into the other side. Squeeze and contract, over into the other side, squeeze and contract. Now, it's very important that you hold your posture here when you're starting to work with these hip locks. If your pelvis is not tucked, the emphasis is going to end up on the lower back. You're going to be feeling the contraction back here, which is very bad for the back, and it's also not going to show off the move the way you want it to. So make sure you keep that pelvis tucked under, and also make sure that the knees are bent. If the knees are not bent, you don't have that range of motion to move those hips. So we're right down here. So we're creating those vertical hip locks by working those two muscle contractions at the same time. We're going to take that into our next drill. So the next drill is going to be very similar to the last two in formation. We're just going to be changing it up a little bit. So we're going to start with our feet just on the floor. We're going to start with half-time hips on your left. We're going to be doing the 16 counts and then 16 counts adding the arms up and down. So we're going to start at the halftime, which will look like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. On your left. We're going to hold that for 16 counts, and then you're going to add the arms. So you're going to go up, 2, 3, 4. Down, 6, 7, 8. Up, 2, 3, 4. Down, at your side for the change. The change is going to be going to full-time hip on the left, which looks like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. So for this whole drill, your starting beat is going to be on your left side. So we do that 16 counts in place. We add the arms for 16 counts. We hold at the side for the change. The change is going to be adding a twist on the hip, the left hip, going forward and back. So you're going to be doing your full-time hip on the left. You're going to add a twist forward. One, two, three, four, back. Six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, back. Six, seven, eight. Then you do that again with the arms up and down. Let me just show you what that looks like. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. You're going to take a little inhale, exhale, and then we're going to start the drill over. It's going to be the same exact drill that you do, but the thing that you're going to change on the second time through is you're going to be adding a step touch. Okay, so step touch, also known as basic Egyptian, you're simply going to start on the left side by pulling that left foot up into a touched position. And then after eight counts, you're going to step, change. Step, change. Every eight counts. So it'll be the same drill, just changing the footwork in that step touch pattern every eight counts. Now, what this drill does is it trains us to have to rely on the muscles and not the legs. So I don't want you pumping from the legs on the step touch, which is a common movement and a proper movement. We can do this move, but it's just not what we're doing today. So I don't want you pushing the hips from the legs. I want you pushing the hips from the muscles. So as you're doing the hip work at halftime and you add that step touch, it would look like this. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, change. 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 If we did it at full time, your hips are here. One and two, three, four, five, six, seven, change. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, change. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, change. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, hold. So as you can see, the changing of my feet should not have any impact on my hips at all. I'm still going to keep it starting beat on the left side, whether my foot is touched on the left or whether my foot is touched on the right. So again, pay attention to that. Whether you're halftime or full time, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. You're here on the left foot pulled up. Change. I'm going to pull up the right foot, but I'm keeping that accent on the left. It would look the same with the full time. Full time, my hips are hitting on the left, and it's going to stay that way when I pull up left foot. It's going to stay that way even when I change to the right foot. Okay, so I really have to rely on these muscles to make that nice sharp lock for me. I can't use the legs. That's what's going to throw you off on this drill, is if you're trying to push. Yeah, that's our habit. So we're trying to create new habits here. We're trying to make ourselves a more in-control dancer by really making sure that we can power our movements from other areas of the body and not just the legs. Let's give it a try with some music. Five, six, seven, eight. You have eight more right here in place. Locking those hips. Starting beat left. Arms. Take it down. Make sure you're keeping those hips inside the body. Working those muscle groups. Full time. Keep that pelvis tucked. Arms up and down. Control that movement. Watch that posture. Add the twist. Front, two, three, four, back. Front, don't lose the technique. Arms up one more time, rest them at the side. Take a little inhale, pull that foot up in demi point on the left. Same drill, changing every eight counts. There was your change. Add the arms, change the feet. Full time. Five, six, seven, change. Right foot up. Five, six, add the arms. Change the foot. Change the foot. change the foot, twist it forward. Add the arms, change the foot. Change the foot. Awesome job. We're now going to take our isolations to the upper body. So once again, whenever we're working in isolation, we want to make sure that the body part we're working is the only part on the body that's moving. Everything else is going to stay perfectly still and in proper posture. So for example, when we're going to work with the upper body, we actually want to remove the middle back and the lower back. One common thing that I see students doing is that they work both the upper and the lower body together. That's not an isolation, right? So to really focalize the movement of the upper body, we want to keep the lower body stationary. That way we get a more accented movement, focalized movement in the upper body. So again, I want you to just pay attention to the subtle difference of making sure you keep that pelvis tucked, which is the posture we talked about earlier. So we're going to start with vertical chest isolations, which means we're going to be working on the up and down plane. So the muscle groups that we really want to have help assist us in that is going to be the upper abdominal and the upper back. So we're going to be in between the shoulder blades, and then we're also going to use this upper abdominal guy. So if we just start through range of motion, lifting that rib cage up and down, I just want you to find your comfort level with your flexibility, right? So it's always up to you on how big or how small you prefer your movements, especially your upper body movements, right? So you want to get in front of the mirror and find where that is for you. So to create a lock, just like we did on the lower body, we're going to use that muscle to help put that pause in there. We want to pause the movement. So we're going to take it up and pause. Lift. We're going to take it down and pause. Drop. We're going to take it up and pause. Lift. And we're going to take it down and pause. Drop. Sometimes just thinking like that, just thinking pause or stop, is all that you need to really make that sharp lock. Some people really need to hear which muscles are working, and other people just need to have that pause or that stop in there. So again, when we go up, you're going to think of squeezing shoulder blades together. When we go down, you're going to absorb that movement into the upper abdominal. Up, down. Up, down. Up, down, up, down. So this is a very one-dimensional move, right? We're just going up and down. Once you learn all the different ways that you can go on your own, you can play with some of the more dimensional moves like circles, figure eights. But first you have to master the one-dimensional moves. Also, our next combination is going to be using the locks up and down with another movement that I call is a micro. So you're going to be working in levels of getting to your highest point on the chest lock up. So if we want to do it on the way up, we're going to go one, two. On the way down, we're going to go three, four. One, two, three, four. Up, up, down, down. Up, up, down, down. I especially like this movement for drum solos because you get those extra accents in there and you want to expand your dance vocabulary. You want to have something else to work with. So if you've been showing off a chest lock over and over and over, this is just another way to add a little variety to the same movement, giving you a little bit more movements to work with in your dance vocabulary. So you're still locking both of those moves on the way up, 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 and then you're going to lock them again, both of them on the way down, down, down. Make sure again that you keep that pelvis tucked under, yeah? So no movement in the pelvic whatsoever. One, two, one, two. One, two, one, two. One, two, one, two. One, two, one, two. So you want both of those movements on the micros to be about the same in size and the same in strength. So our combination is going to start, you're going to do four chest locks starting up, starting accent up. You're going to go one, two, three, four, up, up, down, down, up, down, up. Okay, so you're going to end that measure with three locks, up, down, up, and what that's going to do is set you up for a change of starting beat to go down. Down, two, three, four, down, down, up, up, down, up, down. Again, you're set up to go back up. One, two, three, four, up, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, two, three, four, down, down, up, up, down, up, down. We're going to cycle through that for four measures, and then you're going to change the drill just a little bit. You're going to be starting with the micros for six counts, and then you're going to change to just locks on seven and eight. So you're going to go one and two and three and four and five and six and seven and eight. Let's try that again. Now you're going to start down. One and two and three and four and five and six and seven and eight. So then you're going to keep repeating that for the next two measures. So let's go ahead and try that with some music. Okay, here we go. Arms up, ready for that drill. Five, six, seven, and up. Two, three, four, up, up, down, down, up, down, up. Change it to the down. Down, down, up, up, up. Up, up, down, down, one, two, three, down. Down, down, up, up, one, two, three. I'm going to give you the back view so that you can see what's happening. On five, six, five, six, here we go. It's up, two, three, four, up, up, down, down, one, two, three, down. Down, down, up, up, one, two, three, it's up. Up, up, down, down, one, two, three, change down. Down, down, up, up, one, two, three. Make sure that you keep that upper body isolated. Down. Down, down, up, up, one, two, three. Again, let's try that to the front. I really want you to make sure that you keep your upper body isolated away from the lower body. No movement down here. Let's try it with the arms up. Five, six, here we go. Up, up, down, down, one, two, three. Down, down, up, up, one, two, three, up. Up, up, down, down, one, two, three, down. Down, down, up, up, one, two, three. Up, up, down, down, one, two, three, last time. Now let's change it into the other drill where we're gonna move that rib cage with the micros in the first half, and then we're gonna change to the three locks on the very end, seven and eight. Five, six, here we go. One and two and three and four and five and six and seven and eight. One and two and three and four and five and six and seven and eight. One and two and. Down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, down, up, down, up, up. It's up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, down, up again. One more. Let's try that again with the arms up. What you're going to notice is that when you have the arms in a lifted position, it gets a little harder to maneuver the chest. But it's a good drill to make sure that you're doing the movement properly and you're using all the right muscles. And I also really want you to focus on making two defined movements with those micros. Five, six, here we go. One and two and one and two and one and two and up, down, up. Down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, one and two. Up, up. Give me a couple more. Great job. We're going to do that same drill and we're going to put some feet on it. So we're going to take that drill now and we're going to add some feet to it. But before we do that, I want to take just a second to talk again about the chest. So one thing that's really important when you're working your upper body isolations is that you're not using your breath to make the movement. So you're breathing normally through the movement. What happens a lot is we tie that movement to a breath and we feel like our breath is getting taken away from us or forced out when we have to make that movement. So I want to make sure that as you're practicing at home or training this drill, that you make sure that you're taking normal breaths through the movement, right? So I'm actually able to talk to you while I'm doing this because I'm not using my diaphragm. I'm not using my breath. I'm using muscles. So that's also how you should feel when you're practicing that one. So if you feel like it's taking your breath away, you're probably tying your diaphragm in with the movement. So just try to relax that Sometimes it takes a lot of repetition before you'll actually get it, but when you do, you'll notice that you're able to breathe and talk freely through the movement. So the feet, we're going to be doing the same drill on the upper body. All our feet are going to be doing is marching in place. We're going to hold the beat on the left foot. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we're walking at the halftime speed, holding that tempo, starting beat on the left foot. Okay, so the thing you're going to notice here is that you're going to have two different tempos you're working with. Actually, more than that, because you're going to be working with one tempo on the feet and then a changing tempos on the chest. So that's the part that's a little tricky, but it's also the part that's really fun and cool to watch. So we're going to start by going literal movements of the chest and the foot together. You're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. That's one chest movement per footstep. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now you're going to move into those micro movements, getting 2 per step. 5 and 6 and. Now you're going to go back to those singles, but one is going to speed up. 7 and, which happens on the left foot. 8 on the right foot. Then you're going to reverse the drill to go down. So let's try that one more time. 7, 8. It's up, down. Step, step. Up, up, down, down, up, down, up. Okay, let's break down that up, up, down, down part. So you step left foot with an up, up. You step right foot with a down, down. You step left foot with an up, down. You step right foot up. Let's try just that second half again. I'm also going to give you the back view so that you can see what that looks like from the back as well. So you are starting left foot on the micros going up. 7, 8, up, up, down, down, up, down, up. 7, 8, up, up, down, down, up, down, up. Up, up, down, down, up, down, up. The whole drill starting with the 4 locks. 7, 8, it's 1, 2, 3, 4. Up, up, down, down, up, down, up. Then you would reverse it. So now when we reverse it, it's going to be the exact opposite starting also on your left foot. So let's give that one a try now. Chest locking down. 7, 8, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up, down. Step, 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 step. So it can definitely feel kind of tricky to be working with changing tempos on the upper body while you're trying to hold steady on the foot. And that is actually going to take us into the next secret later, where we're going to be working on timing, which is very, very important for drum solos, but you're going to get a little taste of it right now. So let me show you the drill one more time, and then we're going to add it to music. So your first 4 measures are going to be the drill where you're alternating the 4 locks with the micros, which go like this. 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and 7, and 8. You're going to do that 2 more times before you switch into the changing, where you're going to go micros first, ending 7 and 8 with the 3 locks. So that's going to also start on the left foot, and you're going to start going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, down, up, down. Up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, 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 down, up. So it's actually, the concepts are the exact same as the first combo sequence. So nothing's different there, it's just how you're putting it all together. So you're going to do the first one for 4 measures, following with this one for the last 4 measures. Looks like this. 7, 8, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and 7, and 8. Down, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and 7, and 8. We repeat it, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 7, and 8. We go down, 2, 3, 4, down, down, up, up, down, up, down. Then we switch. Now we change to the micros in the first half of the measure, and we start with the ups on the left foot. Up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, down, up, down. 1 and 2, 3 and 4 and 5 and 6 and 7 and 8, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 5 and 6 and 7 and 8. Great, so just make sure that if you need to pause, get in front of a mirror, watch yourself, watch your posture, watch the body, make sure you can see what it is that you're doing. It never makes sense to practice something if you're not absolutely sure that everything is right. You wanna make sure that your posture is right, you wanna make sure that you're executing the movements and the technique in the right way before you just randomly try to keep up with one of these drills. So take your time, be patient, you're doing a great job. Let's try that with some music. Here we go. 5, 6, 7, and up. 2, 3, 4. Up, up, down, down, up, down, up, down. 2, 3, 4. Down, down, up, up, down, up, down. Again, up. Up, up, down, down, up, down, up, down. Down, down, up, up. Change. Up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down. 1, 2, 3. Down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up. 1, 2, 3. Last one. Great job. So now we're going to work on the horizontal plane with our chest locks. We want to take that horizontally forward and back, and we're also going to take it horizontally side to side. So again, you have dozens of accents in your drum solo, so it's really nice to show the variety from the vertical to the horizontal. It gives you so much more to work with. So we were just going vertically up and down. Now we want to go vertically or horizontally forward and back. This is where we're going to start. It's the same exact muscle groups that are going to be working for you. It's still going to be coming into the upper ab, and it's also going to be coming from the upper back. We're just going to use them in a different way so that we stay on that horizontal plane. So go ahead, and with me, I want you to try sliding the entire rib cage forward, and then I want you to slide it back into that upper ab. So again, what we need to make sure is that we keep that pelvis tucked. One thing you don't want to happen, and since you don't have the instructor right there with you in the room, you want to make sure that you're always checking your posture and making sure that you're keeping that pelvis tucked. I want to show you what happens when you don't tuck the pelvis. And it's a common mistake because your body naturally wants to do the counterbalancing for you. So what happens is as you push that rib cage forward, the pelvic untucks and releases. And as you pull it back is when you pull the pelvic back in. But what you want to do is you want to go ahead and fight against that. Keep that pelvic tucked as you slide ribcage forward and slide it back. It might feel kind of funny, and you may not be sure that you're doing it correctly unless you step in front of a mirror and watch the ribcage actually sliding horizontally forward and back, back, forward, back, forward, back, forward, back. It helps students a lot to place the hands on the hips when they're doing this move. It really helps to make sure you're keeping that pelvic tucked under. You'll really be able to feel it come untucked with the hands there. Forward, back, forward, back. Now I want you to think of locking it. Think of putting that pause, 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 sharp, sharp. Notice again that I'm able to talk to you normally through the movement because I'm not engaging the diaphragm. I'm breathing normally. I'm using muscles, not the breath. Back, forward, back, forward, back. Putting the pause, putting the stop in there to create the lock. Stop, 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 stop. We also have horizontal movements that go side to side. So you can keep the hands here. Again, I want you to check the posture. Knees are bent, pelvis is tucked, shoulders are relaxed, you're breathing. We're going to slide that rib cage side to side, left to right. I want you to go ahead and take the entire rib cage and slide it over. Bring it back through the center, slide it over. Back through the center and slide, slide, slide. So again, we're really going to get those oblique muscles working for us. They're going to help us push that rib cage side to side. Make sure that you're staying on the horizontal plane. Slide it. Slide, slide. Keep the pelvis tucked under. Slide, 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 slide. And again, you may need to get in front of the mirror to make sure that you're not counterbalancing, but sometimes what happens is you want to push the hip out to counterbalance the chest. But we don't want to do that today. We're isolating. Isolating means we're just working one body part, and that's the upper body. Push, push. Now go ahead and create the lock. Lock, lock. Sharp, 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 sharp. The size of your movement is up to you. You can make these as big as you want to if you're really flexible, if you're strong, or you can make them smaller. And making them smaller doesn't mean that they don't look as good. They can look just as good if the technique is clean and executed properly. Slide, slide. You never want to hurt yourself. If you feel like this is uncomfortable to really push the rib cage out so far, then draw it back in just a little bit to where it feels comfortable and where you're able to control it and keep the posture. Slide, 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 slide. Good, so we're gonna break down the next drill that we're gonna do. We're gonna be working with the horizontal chest slides, and we're gonna put it on top of a marching in place footstep. So again, we'll go ahead and march with the left foot leading. We're gonna go one, two, three, four, exactly as we did in the last drill. And the rib cage is also gonna start by pushing to the left. So you're gonna do one slide with each step to start. Slide, 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 step, 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 push, push, push. It can get a little harder to control it as you're thinking about two things, right? You're thinking about stepping and you're thinking about sliding. But as you keep practicing over and over, it'll get a little bit easier. Push, 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 push. Okay, so the drill that we're going to start with is going to be eight counts. The chest is going to go one, two, three, four, five, six. You're going to speed up the tempo on seven and eight, just like we did in the other one. Seven and eight. What that little tempo change does is it allows you to do the alternation of changing starting beats. So that then your ribcage slide is going to start over to your right side. Same drill. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. So let's try to put that on with the foot pattern, which is just marching in place. You're just stepping left foot, right foot. Five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. That's the tricky part. So with that tempo change, that means you're going to get a seven and on the left foot, eight on the right foot. Just try that with me a couple times. Seven and eight. Here we go. Seven and eight. So that's two slides on the left foot, one slide on the right. Let's put that together again. Seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Now, you're going to change the starting beat on the chest, but you're going to keep it the same on the foot, which is going to be left foot and now right chest. Seven, eight. So you're going to be moving in opposition. This one may feel a little bit trickier because of that. So you're stepping left foot, sliding the rib cage over to the right. Let's just try that a couple times. Just step, slide the rib cage in opposition. So I'm stepping left foot, slide right, right foot, slide left. Left foot, slide right, right foot, slide left. Slide, slide, opposition. Stepping left, sliding right. Stepping right, sliding left. Slide, slide. Pushing the rib cage away from the foot to the opposite direction. Step, step, slide it away, slide, slide, slide. Are you checking your posture? Auto check. Always make sure you're keeping that pelvic tucked under. Knees are softly bent. Shoulders are down and relaxed. Energy through the hands and the fingers, no matter where they are. You don't always have to follow my arm positions. You can place them wherever feels good to you. I'm going to actually change my arms to go up. As we talked about earlier, it gets a little harder to control the rib cage when the arms are up, so it's good to practice that way. Let's do the opposition drill now. It's the same drill as the last one we did. It's going to go one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. So then when we finish that one, it's going to bring us right back into the first sequence, which is literal, same sliding chest to the same as the foot starts. So it's a left foot, sliding chest to the left. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Changing it to opposition. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Keep it going. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. It's opposite. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight, and the same. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. So the drill is going to start with that sequence. Then we're going to speed it up so that you're actually doing what we just did, but doing it in four counts. That's going to look like this. We're going to start with the same and then change it to the opposite as well. One, two, three, and four. Five, six, seven, and eight. One, two, three, and four. Five, six, seven, and eight. Again, one, two, three, and four. Five, six, seven, and eight. One, two, three, and four. Five, six, seven, and eight. The last piece of the puzzle is going to be taking that ribcage slide up to the full-time speed. You're going to go one and two and three and four and five and six and seven and eight and. That's two slides per step. And we're also going to be going literal and opposite. Same and opposite. Same sliding to the same direction as the step and then sliding away from the step. So let's try it with the same. Seven, eight, it's one and two and three and four and five and six and seven and eight and. So what you notice at this full-time speed is the changing starting beat happens with each step. One and two and the same and opposite. One and two and three and four and one and two, three and four and. What we're going to do is we're going to end up putting a forward and back and an up and a down. So what we want to do now is we want to show the variety between the horizontal and the vertical. So you're going to be going forward, back, up, and down. Forward, back, up, down. Think of the letter L, right? So you're going forward, pull back, lift up, down. This drill, you really have to show the difference between the horizontal and the vertical, because if you don't, then the drill doesn't make sense, right? So the whole point is to show the difference, the contrast between the horizontal movement and the vertical movement. Forward, back, up, down. Forward, back, up, down. Forward, back, up, down. Forward, back, up, down. Okay, so that final part of the drill is going to have you going full time sliding on the rib cage. You're going to go one and two and three and four, five and six and seven and eight and. And then you're going to repeat, only you're going to start the slide on the left instead of the right. So the first eight counts, you start that full time slide going to your left. The second time, you're going to start it going to your right. Seven, eight. One and two and three and four and five and six and forward, back, up, down. Now start it in opposition, left foot, right slide. One and two, three and four and five and six and seven and eight and. Okay, so the whole drill is going to look like this. You're going to go one, two, three, four, five, six, seven and eight. Change opposite. Two, three, four, five, six, seven and eight. We're going to do that four times through. Five, six, seven and eight. And one, two, three, four, five, six, seven and eight. Change full time. One and two, three and four. Five and six, seven and eight. Now, here's the change. Same thing, but you're going to do full time going to your right with the left foot. One and two, three and four, five and six, forward, back, up, take it back, chest to the left, three and four, and five and six, and forward, back, up, change chest to the right, full time, and four, five and six, forward, back, up, down. Take as much time as you need to practice that. There's no rush. The good news is that this is a DVD and you can practice as many times as you need to. You've heard me say it before. It never makes sense to practice something the wrong way. So make sure you really know what it is that you're doing before you practice. And we're going to try that drill next with the music. Five, six, starting on the left. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. You should be in opposition now. Seven and eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. One, two, three, four, five, six. Take it to full time. One, and two, and three, and four, and five, and six, and forward, back, up, down. Change it to the right. Five, six, forward, back, up, change left. Full time. Five and six, forward, back, up, change. Five, six, forward, back, up, down. Great job. Make sure that when you practice that, you can also try it with the arms up, down, wherever you like, but change those arms up a few times. We're going to go ahead and take those isolations back down into the hips. This time we're going to work horizontally, so we had a little taste for the horizontal movement on the upper body, so now let's place it on the lower body. We call these twists. And twists are a nice accent. They're a lot of fun, especially for a drum solo, especially when you're locking them. So you may be more familiar with your soft twisting motion. We're going to go ahead and lock these. So we're going to use the same exact muscles. We're going to be using the core, the obliques, and we are also going to incorporate a glute squeeze in there too. What we want to do is we want to bring that hip to the front and lock it into place. We want to stop the movement, right? So we want to go ahead and do that on both sides. Twist that hip forward, stop, stop, stop. So our posture is really crucial on these guys. We have to make sure that that pelvis stays tucked under. If we don't, as soon as you untuck the pelvic, you're probably going to start getting vertical movement. So in order to make sure that you're keeping those hips on the horizontal plane, you want to make sure that that pelvis is tucked in nice and tight. We also want to make sure that you get some time in front of the mirror and that you can watch that movement. Twist, 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 twist. Using that core, that oblique, using that glute muscle, squeeze, squeeze. I'm squeezing everything on the same side. So when I bring that left hip to the front, I'm squeezing the oblique to get there, but then I'm squeezing in the glute to stop. You might feel that everything from the knee up is tensing, and that's okay. You just want to keep the knees bent, so you're not actually like slamming that knee back or anything to make the movement happen. It's coming from the muscle. One, two, three, four. Have a look at my knees and see how I'm keeping them in that soft plié at all times. And I'm keeping the pelvic tucked in. And I'm also paying attention to all those other points of posture that we talked about earlier. Twist, 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 twist. Great. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a little drill where we alternate back and forth from vertical isolations to the horizontal isolation. So one thing that I see very common is that people place these movements somewhere in the middle. They don't necessarily give it a horizontal or a vertical. They're just kind of in the middle somewhere. So again, we talked about expanding our dance vocabulary, making sure we have more moves to work with all those accents that we have in a drum solo. So if you're just randomly placing the moves without thinking about it, you're cutting yourself short and you're limiting your vocabulary. So in order to expand it, we're really going to focus on horizontal, vertical. Okay, so the drill is going to look like this. We're going to go twist, twist for four, change vertical for four. Twist, two, three, four, vertical, six, seven, eight. Horizontal, two, three, four, vertical, six. Remember, we want to keep those movements small inside the body. We want to check that posture. Pelvic is always tucked in. Up, six, seven, eight. I'm keeping the knees bent. Five, six, seven, eight. The move is going to feel slightly different as you change from horizontal to vertical. and it should definitely look different. So when you have the opportunity to practice this in the mirror, you want to see the difference between your horizontal movement and then your vertical movement. We're going to add the feet to that. So it's going to be the same exact drill. You're just going to take a step with each movement. So you're going to be stepping left foot with the left twist forward. 1, 2, 3, 4, change to verticals. Now that we're stepping with it, what we're actually doing is an up. 3, 4, hip up, 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 up. 1, 2, 3, 4, up, 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 up. 1, 2, 3, 4, up, 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 up. That's going to be the drill. Let's go ahead and try that with some music. 5, 6, on your left. 1, 2, 3, 4, up, 6, 7, 8. Twist, twist, twist. Vertical. Horizontal. Vertical. Horizontal. Vertical. I want you to feel the difference. Control those hips. Keep that seat tucked in. Horizontal movement. Push those hips to the front. Pull those hips up into the body. Up. Try the arms up. Twist, twist, twist. Lift, lift, lift. Horizontal. Up. Horizontal. Up. Horizontal, up, last time, we're going to speed it up, here we go, 1, 2, 3, 4, now here we go, twist, 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 up, 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 twist, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, horizontal, vertical. Try it on releve. Tippy toes. Twist, 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 lift, 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 lift. Twist. Up. Watch the posture. Arms up. Up, 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 up. Twist. Up. Twist. Up. It's a really good core workout. Twist. Take it to twos. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Twist, twist, lift, lift, twist, twist, lift, lift. Where's the pelvic? Is it tucked under? The chest, are you lifted? Are you breathing? What about the arms? Are they waving uncontrollably? Keep them right at the sides. Again, take as much time as you need with that drill until you feel like you've mastered it. Working with the horizontal locks that we learned for the upper body and the lower body now, we're going to put them together in a fun and funky combination. You're going to start right hip. Go ahead and pull that right foot up into demi point. You're going to twist the hip forward. 1. You're going to slide the rib cage forward for a lock on. 2. Head is going to look. 3. Head is going to look back. 4. Chest is going to slide back. 5. Hip is going to hold. 6. And then it's going to come back. We're actually going to be doing it a little faster, so your tempo is going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. So let's go ahead and see what that looks like. Take the arms out to side or front, wherever you're comfortable. 1, 2, 3, 4. So you're going to hold that last and in between the 3 and the 4 there. Hold the hip in place and then bring it back on the 4. 7, 8. 1, 2, 3. Hold 4. 1, 2, 3. Hold 4. One and two and three, hold four. One and two and three, hold four. Twist, slide, look, look, slide, twist. One and two and three, four. 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 Make sure that you try that on both sides, your right side and your left side. We're going to go ahead and try that now with music. Twist, slide, look, look, slide, twist. Twist, slide, look, look, slide, twist. Keep it horizontal. Great job. Moving on to our next isolation is going to be pelvic isolations. So this is another one that I feel is not demonstrated very well by a lot of dancers, especially for drum solo. So if you remember, what we've been talking about is that in drum solo, the movements have to become smaller. They're more minimized so that you can move quicker to those accents of the drum solo. And we talked about earlier about making sure that you're cleaning up your dance vocabulary, that you're really showing the difference between something like a horizontal and vertical movement. And then the other thing that happens a lot, especially with the pelvics, is I see a lot of dancers using the abdominals. The abdominals actually have nothing to do with your pelvic movements. Your pelvic movements are coming mostly from the psoas and the hip joint. So when we're lifting that pelvic up and down, as you can see, if you see from the side here, I don't have any movement coming from my abdominals whatsoever. I just don't need them. What ends up happening is that we think we need them because we overcontract. And it's also just that tangible feeling of, oh, I'm really moving, I'm really doing something. But the thing is you don't need them. So you're going to want to train yourself to go ahead and relax those abdominal muscles as much as possible. One thing I think that happens when we do that and you're isolating just the pelvic movement without the abdominals, you get a much cleaner and sharper defined movement. So it goes much better with the accents that you're going to hear in the drum solo. And plus, if I wanted to do something like a tummy roll after a pelvic, it's going to show much better than if I was pulling in the abdominals. Because I already did that, then I wouldn't show off the roll. So let me give you a couple examples of that. If I'm doing my pelvic locks, I'm locking up and I'm locking down. You can see that I'm not moving any abdominal muscles whatsoever. My abdominal muscles are nice and relaxed. Now I want you to see what it looks like when I engage the abdominal muscles, which actually have nothing to do with the movement. It's just a secondary movement that I put on top. And as I said earlier, if I want to have a nice, clean movement, I want to keep those abdominals relaxed. And again, if I want to expand that dance vocabulary, then I can go right from that into a tummy roll. But if I'm already engaging those at the same time, doing a tummy roll after just isn't going to show off as nicely. So we're cleaning up our dance vocabulary, giving ourselves a whole lot more to work with here. So let's talk about the technique of how we make that happen. I want you to take your hands, put them right over the hip joints here. These muscles are called the psoas. You're going to open the hip joint and you're going to close the hip joint. You're going to feel that on the palms of your hands. So I'm actually going to be making the locking motion of the pelvic by working from that. So for the pelvic lock up, I'm going to close the hip joint for the most part all the way, and that's going to be the wall of flexibility. I cannot go any further than that, and that is where I'm going to get the lock from. It's what's going to stop the motion is the hip joint closing. Stop, 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 close, close. I want you to make sure that you're keeping your glutes relaxed. You also don't need a glute squeeze or contraction to make this happen. You're simply bringing that pelvic bones up, up, closing the hip joint. Of course, you're having some intrinsic internal muscles working for you. They're the kind of muscles that you don't have to think about. They're automatically doing their job, so you don't need to make any additional squeezes or contractions here. Just think of lifting that pelvic all the way up, closing the hip joint. Up, up, up. Relax the tummy. No movement in the tummy. Sometimes placing your hand on the abdominals will help you, will help your brain to process what you're trying to do and relax those abdominals. You just have to tell yourself over and over and over, relax, relax. Try to take deep breaths. If you feel those muscles engaging, keep telling yourself to release them. Up, up, lock, make it sharp. Sharp, sharp, sharp. We're gonna switch that movement, lock it down, drop. Now the drop is a little different. You're opening the hip joints here. You wanna keep that contraction in the lowest part of the spine possible. So it's almost in the sacrum. It's all the way down at the bottom. If you see my side, you're gonna see that I keep that contraction in the very lowest part of my back. I'm actually eliminating the middle part of my back. So like we talked about earlier, we're no longer isolating once we engage the upper body with the lower body. That's not an isolation. An isolation is a movement that goes all by itself. So I have to work from the waist down. No middle back and no upper back. So again, I'm gonna demonstrate for you what that looks like. Here's a proper pelvic lock down, drop, drop. My abdominals are relaxed. My glutes are pretty relaxed. And I'm keeping that contraction in the lowest part of the spine. Now I'm gonna show you what it looks like if I'm not keeping the contraction where it's supposed to be, which is gonna come into the middle part of the back. It's gonna start to take away from that isolation, right? Because now I'm moving my torso as well as my chest. Not an isolation and not what we want for drum solo. Doesn't mean that you can't do that. It just means you don't want to necessarily do that for drum solo if you want to show off an isolation. So here we go again, dropping the pelvic, drop, 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 drop. Opening, opening. What I want you to think is I want you to think stop. Stop the movement. You might feel a little tightening in the glutes, which is just helping you stop that movement from going any further. It's not a very sharp contraction, but it's a little one. And again, you have intrinsic muscles that are gonna help you make that happen. You don't have to think of squeezing anything else. Drop, drop. Hip joints are open, open, open. Drop, drop. I want you to see what it looks like from the back. I could actually do this lock, I could do this accent as a movement with my back to the audience, and it should translate clean, crisp, and right on with the accent. Drop, drop, drop. Think of lifting the sacrum up, 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 up. Drop the pelvic, drop the pelvic, drop the pelvic, drop, 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 drop. Drop. So now we learned the lift and the drop. We can put those together. Drop, lift, drop, lift. We are actually going to put those together. We're going to create a three-quarter style pelvic lock. So we're going to start with the pelvic lock up. One, two, three. Let's try that again. Up, down, up. Up, down, up. Remembering all the things we just worked on, keeping the abdominals relaxed, the glutes relaxed. You're going to hold four. And then you're gonna go for pelvic lock down three-quarter style. Down, two, three, hold. Up, two, three, hold. Down, two, three, hold. Up, two, three. Down, two, three. Up, two, three. Down, two, three. Up, two, three. Down, two, three. I'm gonna give you the back view again. Down, two, three. It looks very different from the front than from the back. One, two, three. 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 Keep it in the lowest part of the spine. Don't let it radiate up into the middle back or the upper back. As soon as you do that, you've lost your isolation. One, two, three. One, two, three. On the counts of four and or on the count, on the in-between counts of the one, two, three, hold four, we're gonna be adding a chest lock up and down vertical, which we've already worked on. So the combination is gonna look like this. You're gonna go up, two, three, chest up, change to three-quarter pelvic lock down, down, two, three, chest down. Nice and slow, let's do that again. Let's bring the arms up, seven, eight, up, two, three, chest up, down, two, three, chest down, up, two, three, chest up, down, two, three, chest down, up, two, three, lift, down, two, three, drop, up, two, three, lift, down, two, three, drop, one, two, three, up, down, two, three, drop. The ultimate piece of this combination is going to be we're going to add it to the feet. So that means with each step, you're going to lock the pelvic up three times. That's what three-quarter style means. For one step, you're going to get three pelvic contractions. So we're going to step left foot. You're going to get pelvic up, down, up. Chest lock up. As you switch the weight over into the right foot, you're going to get three-quarter pelvic down, down, two, three, chest down. One, two, three, chest up, down, two, three, chest down. It's left foot, hold it, right foot, hold it. Holding that step for four full counts. Change the weight. One, two, three, lift, down, two, three, drop. One, two, three, lift, down, two, three, drop. That's going to be the next drill that we do with the music. All right, here we go. We're going to take that three-quarter style pelvic lock with the chest lock in between, starting on the left foot, starting with pelvic locks up. On five, six, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, up, down, two, three, drop. Up, two, three, lift, down, drop, up. Up, down, drop, up. Lift, down, drop. One, two, three, lift, drop, two, three. You gotta hold that chest in that lifted position before you drop it. Hold it up. Now drop, up, two, three, lift it down, two, three, drop, up, two, three, lift, down, two, three, drop. One, two, three, up, down, two, three, drop. Try with the arms up. Locking each one. Step, 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 step. Let's actually take that up to speed. Your tempo's gonna go a little bit faster. One, two, three, up, one, two, three, down, one, two, three, up, one, two, three, down. It's gonna look like this. Five, six, seven, and one, two, three, lift, one, two, three, drop, one, two, three, lift, one, two, three, drop, one, two, three, lift, one, two, three, drop, one, two, three, lift, one, two, three, drop. Make sure you're isolating. One, two, three, up, down, up, down, step. It's left foot, right foot, left foot, right foot, left foot, right foot, left foot, right foot. Great job. Go ahead and try that drill with the arms out at different positions. You can try traveling with it side to side. Whenever we march with a drill right here in place, that gives you the freedom to go ahead and travel forward and back, side to side. You don't always have to stay in place. If you've made it this far into the video, congratulations. You've really been working hard on your technique, and it's all about to pay off because now we are going to start working on some of the very most fun stuff that you can do in a drum solo. You might know it as layering. The good news is you've already mastered a few layering drills. Simply adding a hip to a foot is a layer, right? Because you're adding two movements. If we were just doing hips, that's your base. Adding your feet, that's already layer number two. Now we're going to be starting to incorporate even more layers, but first we have to go back to the concept of timing. We talked a little bit about timing earlier, but you really have to be able to master the timing in order to be able to layer, because a lot of times when you're layering at multiple tempos. So we're going to go ahead and do a drill. This one is a really good mind-body exercise, so if you like that, if you like training the brain as well as the body, this is going to be a great one for you. We're going to take the feet up to full time, and we're going to be on releve. So your feet are going to look like this. Again, we'll go ahead and start on the left. Left, right, 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 left. Notice my hips. What we talked about earlier is that it's not your legs that are going to be powering your hip movements. You're powering your hip movements from the core, from the obliques, and from the glutes. So you shouldn't be doing this right now. I just want you stepping without any motion on the hips whatsoever, because the next layer is going to be actually adding the hips at a different tempo. Now this one's going to be a little tricky. Typically, you see faster hip work with slower footwork, but you don't very often see faster footwork with slower hip work, which is what we're going to be doing. So you already know the tempo of the feet. Your hips are going to be working at half time. One, two, three, four. We're actually going to be going one, two, three, four. Okay, so we're going to be putting that on top of those feet that are going full time. So I'm going to go ahead and demonstrate that for you. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one and two, three and four and one and two and three and four and one and two, three and four. So I went ahead and showed you both options. We're going to be doing the slower one that we do every four counts as well as the one that we do every two counts. So let's go ahead and start with the one that we do every four counts. Your left hip is going to be going one, two, three, four. 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 Your step, 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 step. Left hip, right hip. Power those hips from the obliques and the glutes, not from the legs. If you're powering your hips from the legs, you're not going to be able to master this drill. Where's your posture? Make sure that your pelvic is tucked under. I want you to go ahead and speed up the hips to halftime. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Notice my feet. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and step, 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 step. Locking the hips. Everything's much more fun with music, so let's go ahead and try that drill to the music. Let's go ahead and get those feet going. We're going to come up on the releve. You want to keep that posture even up here on them tippy toes. We're going to be stepping starting feet on the left. Full time, looks like this. One and two and three and four and five and six and seven and eight and. Eventually, I'm going to have you traveling side to side, so I want to make sure that you can see how we do that. I'm just pulling in that right foot right behind the left. As I travel the other direction, I'm crossing that left foot right over the right. So, left foot just slightly in front of the right. So right here in center, get those feet going. No hips moving right now, just the feet. You're going to power those hips now from the oblique and the glutes at that nice slower speed, yeah? Five, six, here we go. Left, right, left, travel. Hold it. Lock those hips and hold it in place. Keep that pelvic tucked under. How's that posture? Are you breathing? Hold it right here. We're going to speed up the hips. Your footwork stays right here. Your feet. One and two and three and four and five and six and seven and eight. Hips left, right, left, right. Travel. Bring it back to place. Another layer, add some arms. We You could turn around yourself. Take it back down to the slower speed. Fast. Slow. Fast. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Take it down. 1, 2, 3. Hips come up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Great job. So for our next very exciting layering drill, we're going to be doing three different movements at three different tempos. That is correct. The first movement is going to be our foot pattern. We're going to cross left, touch right, touch left, touch right, touch left. Let me show you that to the back just so you can follow along. 5, 6, 7, and left, touch right. Right, touch, left, touch, right. Eventually, we're going to end up speeding it up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. You could also walk back with it if you're at home practicing, either way. On top of that, we're going to be adding hips. Our hips will be keeping tempo on the left side. We're going to be going full time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Our chest is going to be the last piece to the puzzle. We're going to add the chest on at the slowest speed. The chest is going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, down, 6, 7, 8. Let's go ahead and add the chest just to the foot pattern. So you're going to be going 1, 2, 3, 4, down, 6, 7, 8. Up and hold it, down and hold it. Now let's also add those hips. So your hips are going full time, feet are going half time, chest is going quarter time. So here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, touch, step, touch, walk it back. Cross behind, touch out to the side. Cross behind, touch out to the side. Once you start to get that, I want you to start thinking about adding the chest. You don't actually have to do it yet. You can just say it. 5, 6, 7, 8. Chest up. Hold it. Chest down. Hold it. Chest up. Hold it. Chest down. Hold it. Chest up. Hold it. Chest down. Hold it. Couple things to watch out for when we actually do this drill with the music. Once again, you absolutely must power those hips from the muscles and not from the leg. It's a very common practice to push the hip when you do the touch to the side. It's actually a very beautiful stylized move that I myself love to do. It's just not what we're doing right now. So once again, you're going to do that footwork completely independently of the hips. Watch, my hips are not moving at all. And that is because I want to be able to put the layer of the hips doing the full-time locks independently of that. So we're going to go ahead and try that drill with the music. I'm going to show it to you one time to the back as well so that you really have what it is that we're doing. So you're crossing left foot and your hips are also going left hip. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and here we go. Step, touch. Step, touch, step, touch. Now try to add the chest. Up, hold it. Down, hold it. Up, hold it. Down, hold it. Let's go ahead and try that with the music. We're going to go ahead and get those hips going at full time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And drum solo style, creating locks, nice and sharp, inside the body, pelvic tuck, watch that posture. We're going to add the feet. Here we go. 1, 2, touch, step, touch, step, touch, step, touch. Walk it back. Cross, touch, cross. Don't push on that touching leg. Use the muscle. Cross, touch. Cross, touch. Keep it going. We're going to start to think about adding the chest. The chest would go like this. Up, down. Up, down. Up, down. Up, down. Up, down. Let's try to speed up the chest. Looks like this. Up, down. Up, down. So now the chest is on the same tempo as the feet. Might make it feel a little bit easier to you. Possibly harder as well. Step, touch. Taking it down to just the hips and the feet. Hips are full time. Let's add that chest back in. Up, down, up. Let me go ahead and show you that one time to the back. We're going to keep that faster paced chest, hips going full time. Step, touch, step, touch, step, touch, step, touch. Chest goes up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Try it on the other side, hips going to the left. 5, 6, here we go, cross, touch, add the chest, up, down, up, down, up, down. One more addition to that drill is going to be we're going to take those feet just a little bit faster. Let's try that again. Here we go, let's get those hips going at full time. Same footwork, we're just gonna take it a little faster. Step, touch, step, touch, step, touch, step, touch, step, touch. Add a chest, matching feet. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Back to just the feet and hips. Add the chest. That drill is a very complicated advanced drill, so take your time. Be patient with yourself. You can always break it down step by step. Feet and hips, feet and chest, feet only, hips only, chest only. You always have to take it at your pace and make sure you're breaking it down and doing the proper technique before you try to put it all together. Great job. So you've learned a whole lot of techniques and drills. Unfortunately, you could be the best technician and have the best technique and drills on the planet, but that doesn't necessarily make you a great dancer. Being a great dancer is also going to incorporate having some stage presence. So these next few drum solo highlights are going to help us work on incorporating some stage presence and energy behind our presentation of technique. So we're going to work on a fun opening to a drum solo. I'm going to go ahead and turn my back to you so you can see you're going to actually start the same as me. You're going to imagine that your back is to your audience. And you're just going to be in a pose, weighted right foot, pose out on the left. You're going to hear the music start, and what you're going to do is a sharp, fast head roll around. So the key here is that you don't actually have to do a head roll. You can simply just take the arm overhead, and the head goes with it just slightly. Or if you're feeling in the mood, you could do a really big and dramatic head roll. Let me show you what that looks like to the front. So I'm just arcing the head from side to the front to the side and finishing with the arm. So it's like this. And again, as I said, if you don't want to actually do the head roll, you can get the same dramatic effect just by doing the arm. So let me show you the two options. Just the arm arm with the head roll. Okay, either one of those is going to be just fine for a nice dramatic opening. It's very important that you have a strong pose. So conveying energy to your audience is all about having a very strong posture and a body line. And earlier we talked about our communication center, the chakras of the throat and the heart. This is our communication center, the solar plexus, the heart, and the throat. So if this is closed off and you're not holding a strong posture, you're not communicating with your audience. So the first step to really claim your stage and translate that energy all the way out is to lift the carriage nice and tall. And this is going to also come through in our poses, right? So we're here, or we're here. Strong energy through the arms. Strong poses is going to really translate lots of energy and lots of excitement to your audience. So let's go ahead and try that. We're here. You're going to go to the left and hold it. To the right and hold it. You're going to turn over your shoulder to the left, so you're going to be left profile to your audience. Here, you're going to bring the arms up and hold it. Drop, drop. Change, right profile to your audience, drop, drop. So that sequence again goes left and hold, right and hold. Turn, drop, drop. Turn, drop, drop. Notice again my body and my carriage. I'm very poised, I'm very tall, my arms are strong, my body is strong, my chest is lifted. I'm setting up a very nice frame and a very nice presentation for my drop. Drop, drop. It's not a very complicated move, it just has to be showcased as well as possible. Drop, drop. Nice, sharp, locking hips down. I'm gonna use that glute on the right side to really help me lock those hips. Drop, drop. Same thing on the other side. I'm going to step left foot, place the weight in the left foot, drop, drop. Let's try that one more time. You're here. 7, 8, head roll, hold. Head roll, hold. Turn, drop, drop, step, turn, drop, drop. You're going to repeat. Head roll, hold. Head roll, hold. Turn, you're going to switch the technique from a hip drop to a pelvic drop. Drop, drop, turn, change your last one to a chest, drop, drop. So again, that second time through, you're doing the same head roll and hold, turning over to the left, pelvic drop two times. We already worked on those pelvic locks. Turn, two chest locks down, drop, drop. So again, this is all about your opener. This is your opener to your drum solo. It has to be strong, and you really have to catch the attention of your audience. So you really have to be strong, dynamic, and powerful. It doesn't have to be complicated, it just has to be energetic. We're going to go ahead and try that with the music. Something that I always like to add to my drum solos is an element of fusion, meaning I like to think outside the box, I like to add something different than just your traditional or typical belly dance moves. I really love samba and salsa, and I draw a lot of inspiration from other dance forms. So one of the things you'll see me do a lot is adding samba as well as Tahitian. So one of the moves that we're going to do next is going to be a samba step, and we're going to layer it with some belly dance moves. So your samba step is going to go side, center, center, side, center, center, side, center, center, side, center, center. Eventually we're going to take that pause out of there, and we're just going to be going side, center, center, side, center, center, side, center, center, side, center, center. And I'm going to combine this with a technique that I think is an absolute must in a drum solo, and that is downs. Downs are one of your strongest techniques that you can master, and people just absolutely love to see it in a drum solo. It's pretty much a must when it comes to that. So we're going to put that down on top of the foot pattern. So we haven't really talked about downs in this video yet. A down is a movement where the hip drops down with the actual step. So if I'm going to step left foot, that means my left hip needs to drop down towards the floor. It's those same contractions and glute squeezes that we worked on earlier. It's going to be happening on the opposite side of the step. So your hips work in tandem, right? As one goes down, that means the other one is up. So it's the up contraction that actually gives you the momentum of the move. So you're going to be stepping left foot, and you're going to squeeze and contract the oblique and the glute on the right side to drive that left hip down into the floor. Let's try that one more time on the left side. Down. You're going to step right foot, down. Left foot, down. Down, 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 down. Step, 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 step. So this is your vertical isolations that we worked on earlier. It's just more specifically called a down because of the way it is in incorporation with the feet. Drop, 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 drop. Once you have the down, you can put any kind of foot pattern onto it. So as we mentioned before, the foot pattern we're going to use is Samba step. Side, center, center. Side, center, center. Side, center, center. Side,